Welcome back to Lunar 2. One thing. Apparently, as my research tells me, this is completely based off of, you know, how low Jean's HP is. Which got me to thinking a lot. Where is that ring? The Fiend Ring. It sets her HP to 1. This may or may not be worth it. It entirely depends on how much damage it actually does. If she does like 300 a swing, then it'll be worth it. Where should I go? I need to go somewhere where I can actually fight something with a decent amount of defense just to see. This is not where I want to be. But yeah, if she does like 300 damage a swing, it might be worth it. But that's a whole lot of damage, and I honestly have some significant doubts about it doing that much. So, actually, we could go there. Haven't been there yet. How do I get to the... Where is that? That's, near where Pentagulia used to be, isn't it? I think so. No, I'm in completely the wrong section of the game. No, I can go this way. Again, I really doubt Jean's going to do 300 damage. I honestly don't see it happening. Yeah, let's save. I did some shopping, I did some other things, so, you know, I think it'll be worth saving. Just so I don't need to do it again. It's only a couple minutes, but, you know, I just don't want to do it again. So, Jean, how much damage do you do? Hopefully these things aren't all very, very, very strong versus physical attack. That would kind of ruin my plan. Go nuts, dear! Well, I'm gonna put Burning Rage on top of it, but I'm pretty much going to be doing this forever anyway, so... Jeez! 500 damage? Holy crap. That might actually be worth it. Wow, the experience here and the money is kind of garbage. I might actually roll around like this for a little bit. You know, with Jean at 1 HP. I don't get to see what the enemies do! But that's fine. I'm okay with that. I'll take care of this. That's 314 damage. That's just insane. 500 on a critical, 4 attacks, so she does 1200-ish to maximum of 2000-ish? Oh my. Oh my. Hey, whatever, that works, right? I don't normally deal with weapons like that, because, you know, I don't like walking around with 1 HP, that's kind of dangerous. But at the moment, I think I can do it. Of course, that's going to make this dungeon really easy, but hey, not what I wanted to fight, but whatever. And let's face it, with my 20 starlights, I can basically do this for basically ever. Anyway, Blood Wyvern. Probably just going to die like everything. Well, the harpies. It depends. The only thing that I'm really worried about is encountering something extremely strong versus physical, or things faster than Jean. Well, there she goes. That's fine, though. I mean, she comes back. And if she kills, you know, two enemies in the time that she's alive... I think we can roll with this a little bit longer. Of course, I'm gonna end up with combats like that one where she doesn't do a damn thing, because the first thing the enemy does is get rid of Jean. But that's just an enemy that's slightly faster than she is. So... Ah, treasure. Good. So this isn't, you know, barrenness for, you know, six levels like the Lion's Dungeon was. On the other side, I have combats like that, which Jean just kills everything pretty much instantaneously. So... yeah. You know, RPG, you've already decided on this. Why do you have to keep justifying it? I don't know. It's a little silly, isn't it? How do I get to that chest? Well, RPG, in the recent past, you were complaining about Jean not feeling like she's powerful anymore. That's been basically fixed. Not like defense is going to matter for her. She has 1 HP. Oh, boy. Oh, well. Can't believe I'm running around like this. Like in the last couple of parts of me running away from enemies, this is another thing that I never ever do. I never walk around with, you know, people intentionally at low HP. Usually I ignore an item like this. But when the Fiend Ring is involved too, and I can pretty much guarantee every combat she starts at 1 HP, the Fierce Fist is as powerful as possible. Sure, why not? At the very least, I'm not going to eat through 500 starlights this time around. There is that. Just make sure you don't heal Jean, RPG, because that's a massive waste of MP. She's just going to go down to 1 anyway. 2 more groups dead, and yeah, if Jean only did like 200 damage, I would not be doing this. I wouldn't think it would be worth it. But, you know, I set 300 as the cutoff point. So, hey! New enemies! Good! More things for Jean to murder. Doppelganger. That has me a little bit... I'm just gonna press X a whole bunch of times anyway. That's my strategy currently. Smash X! It's like the end of the regular Grandia. Oh, there goes Jean. That's a pity. Also, speaking of Grandia, as of right now, the website that had the patch for Grandia Redux doesn't work anymore. That's no longer a thing, apparently. That's kind of sad. I do have, like, a patched copy, but I'm kind of wondering if I could just get... No, let's not do that. If I can get the, whatchamacallit out of it, Actually, can we? You turned into Ronfar. Can we steal from you? If I can get the just a patch out of it. Magic Stealer! I should really get on that and try that. Holy crap! Yes, please. 78. Sheesh. Damn it, hero! Kinda wonder if I can take more? Kinda wanna try? Magic Stealer! Oh my goodness gracious. Wow. That is insane. I'm down to just... let's get rid of you. I'm down to just, you know, one charmed person in Lumina. Just sitting here screwing around. Okay, so doppelgangers are the first thing to murder. Unfortunately, everybody else doesn't get the, same benefit of having 1 HP as Jean, so let's get rid of that. That was probably a waste, but that's fine. And level 60. For Hero. Just Hero, but, you know, he was going to be the first anyway. Yeah, it might be a while. Yeah, I actually lost money in that previous dungeon. Like, it was only a few thousand, but I did lose money. Sure, why not? Harpies are pretty much free experience. Not very much, and not a whole lot of silver, but it's fine. It's not really worth equipping the purse, either. Not really. That's a dead end. That's a dead end. Goddess bracelet. Sure, it's probably for Leo. No, he already got his shield. 6 more defense? Why not? I mean, it's free. I mean, you really can't complain about free armor, can you? It'd be kind of silly to do so. So this dungeon isn't bad at all. Thank you, Gene. Oh, boy. What is this place even called, by the way? Is that a new enemy? Have I fought that before? I'm only saving Dragon's Nest. Alright. No, I've definitely fought those before. And Lamina levels. You know, I kind of wish I came here first. Considering this seems a little bit easier than the, other places I've been. Then again, that could be attributed to the fact that I'm a little bit higher than I was when I first started this. Not to mention all the equipment and, well, how Gene's walking around right now. So, there's that. Eh. I guess it really doesn't matter what order I do them in, as long as I do them. Also, Gene getting a slight heal from her ring doesn't really seem to do all that much to her damage. And Gene levels, even though she's on her face behind everyone, she gets to attack, which is... not like it matters. I'm just gonna make sure, I know I'm probably beating a dead horse here, but make sure that I change her equipment before I get into a boss fight. That's probably a really good thing to do. You know what else would be really good, RPG? Healing the rest of your party might be a, you know, somewhat good idea. Sure, why not? It's a little bit of waste, but meh. No point in healing Gene. Is that it? I think that's it. There it is. There are the stairs. Are these the ones I came in from? It might be. I think it is. Okay, I've definitely gotten turned around. We're going down, RPG, not up. Also, the dragon's nest? Is there some sort of dragon here? I would think. Probably not. And Ronfar levels. Honestly, after Gene takes a turn, I kind of wish the enemies would attack her. Just because that's, you know, a turn of attacks that, well, at least one attack that I don't have to heal from. Yeah, Gene going up to HP 42 only drops her attack by about 30 points, but then again, that is a significant number, considering that that's about 10%. Have I used a single Starlight yet? No, I haven't. I can practically heal with herbs at this point. I don't know why I continue to buy them. Just, it's a little bit more that I could carry around, you know? Because otherwise it'd be just, healing nuts, which I didn't buy any of. No, I've used those. Granted, using herbs is kind of annoying. And you go through the whole entire stockpile that you have just healing once. Whatever, it's fine. Huh, doppelganger. Haven't actually had the opportunity to steal MP from them before they turn into somebody. I'd rather cast Burning Rage. Here's the thing. How much does Blue Dragon Palm do the way she's set up? Like, serious question. As long as that one doesn't kill Gene, we're good. That's actually not as much as I expected. her normally attacking is much better. Hmm. Well, the question's been answered. Well, that was a bit odd. The doppelganger turned into Jean and Lamina's magic swiper-ing? She actually got more than when it transformed into Ronfar. You would figure it'd be the other way around. Oh well, I mean, she's back up to full. Yeah, it was, 78-ish for Ronfar and 90 for Jean. The doppelganger trans- Oh, look at you guys. I suppose this is the time to try it, isn't it? Just to see. And zero. Huh? That's really weird. Jean gave... The doppelganger transformed into Jean gave more MP than the Ronfar transformation, but they actually have zero nor... That's just strange. Whatever. And I got 87 from the hero transformed one, so that's... Okay. Either that or I just got really, really crappy rolls when the one that was transformed into Ronfar, that's a possibility. And there's the possibility that the other two have less MP to steal. The Jean transformation and the hero transformation. Oh yeah, chest. I want to get that. I mean, this isn't exactly crappy equipment we're picking up. Dragon Shield. Jean has 42 MP, HP, but that's not going to last very long. Sure. It's just really strange that there's a discrepancy between the characters like that. The doppelganger's transformed. Did I get everything here? Well, you're leaving, RPG. You better have. And Leo levels. Also, I have a really... I gotta go back and look. I feel like I've missed stuff. Damn it, game. You know, usually I'm pretty thorough, but I'm not... I haven't played through this section before, so now I have to go look. I'm actually tempted to go back in the previous level, too. Yeah, we might as well. Just to see if there is anything. There probably isn't. Or, you know, there is. Nameless Sword. That is quite a bit better. Magic defense range, which isn't too bad. 5 defense, which is pretty incredible. And 11 attack. Okay, I guess we're going back to the previous... We're going back to the previous, what, 2 levels? Because I have to look. I'm going to cut out the looking. Let's do that. Okay, I think it's only 1 treasure chest per level. That's what it feels like. And I'm still not back, but, you know, let's ignore that. Yeah, just 1 treasure chest per level. As far as I can tell. Unless I'm missing something really obvious. I mean, that is a possibility. Does this put me back where I was? At least, you know, the doubt actually led to something. It wasn't just, you know, me wasting time. Thankfully, there's that. Anyway, next time, more Lunar. Until then, let's actually save.